Hello students, hope you are doing great. I'm Dr. Suhas Manjunath. Today I'll be lecturing on a slightly different topic which you would have heard of but a little known, that is CGN or Central Government Nomination. For those of the students who would be wondering, I belong to a state where there are no government run institutes offering MS or MD PG courses. Is All India quota only my hope, or do you have any reservation to be claimed for? My answer is yes, there is a chance claiming under the quota CGN or Central Government Nomination. So let's start with it for today. These are some of the FAQs which I would like to answer for today. What is CGN quota? Who are eligible under it? How many seats are being reserved for it? Which are the donor institutes for CGN? Are medical officers needed to attend AIPGT to claim a seat under CGN? What is the age limit for MOs claiming under CGN? Do the candidates claiming for CGN have an option to choose seat of their choice among the donor institutes? How can the applications of CGN be submitted? When is the last date to submit the application? These are some of the points I would like to quote. Firstly, first is deficient state or union territory, in which no government-run college of the respective system or specialty of MD or PG courses for study is existing. Example, Jammu and Kashmir, Tamil Nadu, etc. We'll see which of the deficient states in the coming slides. Then eligible candidates. Those belonging to deficient states or UTs where college of the respective system or specialty of MD or PG courses for study is not available. So we have got two kinds of eligible candidates. First is the sponsored candidates, second is a private candidate. First is sponsored candidates. The nominated candidates who are employees of any deficient state or union territory government run institutions for central government nomination, whose emoluments or fee would be borne during study period of the course by the concerned sponsoring deficient state or union territory government and not by any donor institute. So this is about the sponsored candidates. Private candidates, aspirants or interested candidates who are not in service of any government-run medical institution of the deficient state or union territories and nominated by such states and union territories for admission under central pool reserved seats in donor institution. So under sponsored candidates, will have teachers, MOs or medical officers, research officers, etc. who are government employees of that deficient state or union territory, and the private candidates are excluding of those. Coming to donor institutes, in which institutes seat under central pool are reserved for central government nomination of candidates. This is our roadmap for today. First we'll look about CGN, then coming to eligibility criteria, and at the last we'll see the seat distribution among the donor institutes and against which departments they are reserving particular seats. CGN. Few seats in Ayurveda, Siddha, Unani, Homeopathy, PG, MD courses are reserved under central pool in few donor institutes of the country for the students or candidates of the states or union territories where the colleges of respective system or specialty is not available for studying postgraduate courses. At the start of the lecture, we had seen a scenario. So this explains central government nomination or CGN. Which are the deficient states or union territories? These are the states where there are no government-run institutes offering MD or MS PG courses. Starting with Jammu and Kashmir, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu, Dadra and Nagar Haveli, Goa, Lakshadweep, Sikkim, Arunachal Pradesh, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Manipur, Tripuram, Jharkhand, Mizoram, Andaman and Nicobar, Puducherry and Tamil Nadu. Are you one of the students who belong to these states? If yes, then you will get eligible to apply under CGN or central government nominations. Coming to eligibility criteria, eligibility of two kinds of candidates we had seen before. First is eligibility of sponsored candidates. Second one is eligibility of private candidates. Eligible sponsored candidates, that is teachers, medical officers, research officers, are to be recommended or nominated by the deficient state or union territory governments for nomination as central government nominees for admission in MD or PG courses against the seats earmarked under central pool by the donor institutes or colleges as Government of Institute India's nominees. This is about eligibility of sponsored candidates. They must be either of teachers or medical officers or research officers. Coming to the eligible private candidates, are to be nominated as central government nominees by the deficient states or union territories for admission in MD or PG courses against seats earmarked under central pool by the donor institutes or colleges. Those of the candidates which doesn't come under the earlier categories, they fall into private candidates. This is about eligibility criteria. Coming to the donor institutes, we have got three donor institutes which give seats under CGN. First is IPGTR of Jamnagar, second one NIA of Jaipur, and third one GAC Government Ayurveda College of Guwahati. We'll see how many seats and against which department they're reserving the seats in the further slides. So this is the order of preference for CGN by the Ministry of Ayush. So the Ministry of Ayush has got a particular order in which they prefer candidates under CGN. Firstly, they'll accept or take regular teaching staff with 3 years regular service of any government-run medical institution. These are the first category to be preferred. Say if there are no applications under this category, they next move on to the medical officers, research officers working on regular basis and have rendered 3 years regular service in the government. Note that only one eligible research officer would be nominated by the ministry. Take if there are no applications and this under this category as well, then they will move on to eligible private candidates recommended or nominated by the deficient states or UTs. Say for example, there are no eligible private candidates as well who have applied under CGN, then the seats become vacant. So these vacant seats under the central pool will be filled up by open category candidates by the donor institute according to the merit of the APGT. This filling of vacant seats will occur at the level of donor institutes. So this is about the order of preference. The qualifying criteria necessity for the candidates. For government teachers or medical officers or research officers, they are not subjected to APGT entrance and they are accepted like that itself. But for a private candidate nominated by the deficient states or union territories, they shall be admitted on the basis of marks obtained by them in APGT. So it is necessary for a private candidate to have attended APGT and they will be admitted on the basis of the marks obtained in that exam. This is about qualifying criteria. This is the application form which looks like pro forma for applying for nomination to MD or PG courses in Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha and Homeopathy as central government nominees. Can the candidates have their choices to make with respect to seats in donor institutes? Yes, they have got the chance, but the allotment of the seats occur on based upon three criteria. We'll see what is those three criteria are. The central government reserved seats of MD or PG courses under central pool in the donor institute strictly on the basis of the seniority and the choice of institute or subject opted by the CG nominee and also on availability of seats in the institute. So three criteria being seniority basis, choice of the institute or subject opted and availability of the seat in the institution. Let us take an example. A candidate has applied for Kaya Chikitsa department. So we have got one seat reserved under Kaya Chikitsa department in GSE Guwahati. If a candidate has given preference for Agata Tantra, but Agatha Tantra is not being offered by GSE Guwahati. So like this, preferences also matter, and based upon it, the seats get allotted under CGN category. Other points to be noted is, but once the nominated or sponsored candidate is nominated by the ministry as CGN at his or her preferred institute with preferred subject, he or she is not usually allowed to change his or her nominated institute or subject on personal ground. So once they have given their preferences, they are not allowed to change once again. Second thing is, once the candidates get recommended to the ministry of CGN, CG nomination, are not allowed to withdraw their nomination under any circumstances. They are not allowed to withdraw. Say for example, if they are withdrawn, he or she would be barred at least for 2 years from further nomination as CGN. So these are points to be borne in mind. How can the applications of CGN be submitted? Whether we have to submit the applications directly to Ministry of Ayush, or we have to submit it to the donor institute. We'll see about it. Applications of the sponsored or in-service government teachers or medical officers or research officers may only be forwarded by the deficient state or union territory governments to the Ministry of Ayush. This is important, only to the Ministry of Ayush. Second thing, applications of eligible private candidates from the deficient state or union territories should be forwarded to the concerned donor institutes. I'll repeat, concerned donor institutes only, directly by the nominating deficient states or union territory governments for admissions, as per prospectus or notifications of the donor institute in this regard, and under no circumstances to the Ministry of Ayush. So this is about where the application to be submitted. The age limit, whether the medical officers or the candidates have got any age limit to cater. There is no maximum age limit for nominees, but one clause should get satisfied. That is, it is required to be ensured that only such government employees, whether a teacher or medical officer nominated, shall be able to serve the government for at least 5 years after completion of the MD or PG courses. This is a clause they have to cross with respect to age limit. Coming to the donor institutes and seat distribution. So how many seats are getting distributed across the departments, we'll see now. Here we have got three donor institutes, IPGTRANI and GSE Guwahati. So three seats are being allotted for CGN in IPGTRA Jamnagar, 14 seats in NIA Jaipur, and 2 seats in GSE Guwahati. This makes 19 seats out of 3 donor institutes. These 19 seats, how are they differentiated into different departments? We'll see next. GSE Guwahati, as we saw, has got 2 seats under CGN. So, 1 seat for Kaya Chikitsa and 1 seat for Samhita Siddhanta. Coming to NIA Jaipur, 14 seats. NIA has got 14 departments offered under post-graduation courses. In the coming lectures, we'll see in detail about NIA and IPGTRA Jamnagar. For time being, NIA has got 14 courses offered by NIA. Those departments are Agatha Tantra, Balaroga, Dravya Guna, Kaya Chikitsa, Maulika Siddhanta, Panchakarma, Prasuti Tantra Evam Stree Roga, Roga and Vikriti Vignana, Rasashastra and Vaishajya Kalpana, Sharira Rachana, Sharira Kriya, Shalya Tantra, Shalakya Tantra, and Swastavritta. Each of these 14 departments have got 1 seat each reserved under CGN category. So this is about the seat distribution across the donor institutes. So it makes of 19 seats in total. This is the latest notification which I would like to share, dated 28th of September 2021. I have highlighted the last date of submission of the applications. Fourth point, all applications for nomination to MD or PG courses for the academic session 2021 and 22 of government teachers, medical officers, research officers were not subjected to any entrance test are to be forwarded to the Ministry of Ayush. The letter containing applications for nomination to MD or PG courses of the willing or eligible government candidates of all deficient states or UTs should therefore be addressed to the secretary of this Ministry of Ayush and should reach the ministry latest by October of 29th, 2021. I repeat, October 29th, 2021, except for northeastern states. The last date for receiving applications of CG nomination from northeastern states for 2021-22 will be, however, be November 15, 2021. I'll repeat, November 15, 2021. This is about the last date of submission for CGN. So I've dealt with the donor institutes and the seat distribution, number of seats and each department how many, and the last date of distribution submission of CGN applications. At the start of the lecture, we had seen a few FAQs. I hope I've answered all of these FAQs with sufficient data. With this, I'll like to conclude the lecture for today. We have got lectures coming with respect to the remaining two national institutes and other topics related to APGT admissions and counseling. Thank you. All the very best, students.